man on the back porch, old man on the back porch, old man on the back porch, and that old man is me. Yeah, it's a nice day outside. Guess I'll grab me a cup of coffee and a Mountain Dew, go have a smoke on the back porch, just have a seat right here in my chair. And what the heck? What in blue blazes are you kids doing in my yard? Get out of here. Get out of my yard. What are you being? What? Who am I? I live here. That's who I am. All right. If you must know, my name's Bloodwing. My friends call me BW, but you can call me Mr. Bloodwing. What's that? What do you mean, what do I do? Well, I sit on my back porch here and tell stories about an evil land called PC culture. Terrible people. Third-wave feminists. Tumblr kitties. Social justice warriors. Scary stuff. You kids wouldn't like it. Yes, yes, yes. Just like Baring. What do you mean I'm not as funny as Baring? Well, I'll take that fuzzy Aussie with one hand behind my back, I tell you. I have to find my cane first, though. Now, Sugar Tits, on the other hand, that's a different story. Why, what I wouldn't do, well, you kids never mind. What's that? Yes, like Undoom too. What do you mean I'm not as slick as he is? Of course I know that. And that golden voice of his, I mean, there's just no match to it. But so what? And Suit? Yeah, I like Suit yourself. He's all right guy. But you know, he's really got nothing going for him but Onion Cook and that animation that he does. Sargon, Kraut and Tea? Well, of course I know who they are. What do you mean I'm not as smart as they are? Why, I oughta you little curtain climbers, you. I'll tell you what, I don't care how dumb you think I am. I know I got at least some stories to tell. Tell you what, if you dumb crumb snatchers will sit there and be quiet for a minute, I'll tell you a story. A story about a magical place called the Young Turks. And in this magical place, there's evil creatures like trolls. No, not that troll. She's Sargon and Baring's problem. She's probably off chasing them around somewhere. Good Lord, I hope she don't come around these parts. No, the troll I'm talking about is just as insidious, just as evil. But she'll fool you, because she looks kind of pretty. But deep inside, she's just as evil, just as crafty as ever any troll there ever was. Why, if you make her mad, she'll tell you you're fat and her friends will all spit on you. The name of that troll is Anna. See what I tell you? Really scary. But I gotta admit, in this story, she's not as bad as she usually is. But the story only starts with her. Before long, we'll be talking about some really mean girls that like to pick on 4-year-old little kids. And then we'll be talking about some really evil creatures called third wave feminists. But let's not get ahead of ourselves, shall we? So let's take a look at what Anna the Troll has to say.
Oftentimes when we talk about trolls or bullying on the internet, it involves men going after public figures or people who are vulnerable. But the latest case actually involves a 4-year-old girl who's being bullied by grown women for not being attractive enough.
You can just tell by the look on Anna's face there that she just hates admitting that this isn't a man this time, that it's women she's actually got to talk about. But let's not get ahead of ourselves still. Let's take a look at what else she's got to say.
This little girl is Blue what? Ivy, the daughter of Beyonce and Jay-Z. And I couldn't even believe that this was happening because I thought, hey, you know, regardless of how despicable or disgusting trolls are, usually they stay away from kids. Kids are kind of off limits because they're innocent. They can't protect themselves. They can't defend themselves. But nonetheless, you have grown women tweeting pretty horrendous things about Blue Ivy. So let me tell you what some of those tweets say. One person tweeted, "So are we all just supposed to pretend that Blue Ivy isn't ugly as hell forever?" Okay. Well,
what?
Yep. Another person writes, oh, actually the same woman writes, "Blue Ivy is ugly as sin and there's no way around it. Sorry." Another woman writes, "I'm sorry, but I think Blue Ivy is an ugly baby." And then I'll read you one more. There were many, many more than this,
oh, but
by
she
the way.
Said she's sorry.
Oh, that's okay.
"Blue Ivy, ugly as shit, LOL. Poor thing, looks like her father." Okay, so.
Well, that
I just,
was,
these that women are pigs, okay? And they're horrible. And the fact that you go after a freaking child and talk about the way she looks just shows how devastatingly depressing you are as a person. Like, I don't even know what else to say. It really bothers me because, look, I think that there are feminists who raise a good point about how there's a lot of emphasis on the way women look and it's unfair because men don't get the same type of treatment. That is a very legitimate point. But you know what else is a legitimate point? That women tear one another apart just as much, sometimes even more viciously. And now you're hearing stories about women tearing down a four-year-old?
Even though I think Anna really wants to blame this on, or wishes she could blame it on men here, I gotta hand it to her that she's putting the blame where it lies. And I gotta agree with her, it's pretty vicious. I mean, you just don't do this to a four-year-old. Besides, I don't think that little girl is all that ugly. And I know ugly. One of my grandsons, when he was born, he was so ugly. I mean, the kind of ugly you just want to scream and throw him back where he come from. But he finally grew out of it. He's 6 now, and he's a pretty handsome little guy. And same thing might happen to this little girl. But it was pretty vicious stuff. But let's take a look at the article that was linked in their description, where this story come from. And let's see who really gets the blame here on this situation. Of course, it just had to be the Huffington Post, didn't it? But as you can see, this article is about grown women. Grown adults are calling Blue Ivy ugly on the internet. Below that, which is what we want to pay attention to, this is how women develop self-esteem issues. As we scroll down through the article, we'll find this. In a CNN article, writer Kelly Wallace talks to Sophia Nelson, author of a new self-help book for women called The Woman Code, about this topic. The piece reads, "From the time where little girls were taught to compete," said Nelson during a recent conversation at CNN, "I need to be prettier, taller, smarter. My hair needs to be straighter, curlier, whatever it is. I need to get the better-looking guy. I need to always be better than, because we're taught to come from a place of lack as women. Society teaches us that we must conform to a very specific set of standards crafted by a patriarchal society where women are often viewed as mere objects. We must dress appealingly, but not too provocatively, lest we be labeled promiscuous. We're expected to wear makeup in order to look professional, but are then criticized and considered fake." Oh, come on, guys. You knew that buzzword, patriarchal society, was coming. So as you can see by the article, it's all our fault. You're a man. You have a patriarchal society. We run the show. And because we expect too much out of these women, we expect them to be pretty and take care of themselves. Well, that's the reason that they're mean. It's not their fault. It's because they try to live up to those silly men, to their expectations. But they're not done yet. Scroll down just a little bit farther. In an article from women's culture site, Bustle.com, author Claire Warner discusses the cattiness that can emerge from feelings of inadequacy women experience as a result of constantly being judged on their appearance. Warner asserts women should be praising each other instead of competing, and lists 6 ways feminists can deal with catty women. Our male-dominated world pits women against each other, and in all likelihood, that's why she feels the need to assert her dominance over you, so to speak, Warner writes. Yeah, it's all our fault, because we dominate this world in their eyes. Can't possibly be their fault. Couldn't be some flaw in their character. Maybe they didn't get enough love when they lived at home from their mommies and daddies. Or maybe they're just mean. Maybe they're just wired wrong up there. But no, according to these ladies, it has to be the man's fault. So you see, kiddies, beware of the third wave feminist. They're evil. And no matter what they do, no matter what bad thing they do, they'll blame it on you and everybody else. Because we all know that their poop don't stink. And they never do anything wrong. Now, I've told you a story. And I'm done now. My wrestling's coming on and I can't miss it. So you kids get out of here. I hear your moms calling for you. Go on. Get. Dadgum aggravating little juvenile delinquents. Oh, well. Go watch my wrestling.